People that go and serve in Vietnam, especially people that run through a lot of shit over there, well, they become hip to imperialism and what it means and what their stake in it is, which means for the working class guys, black and white, that they have to go defend it.
One outlook that you can take in, on seeing both sides over in Vietnam, as far as the NVA, which is North Vietnamese Army, and the South Vietnamese Army, which is the Arabs, is that there's a great more solidarity among the North Vietnamese, and they will stick together a lot more than any Arvin soldier. You'll find Arvins will have a real great tendency to like cop out whenever it gets too hot for him, man. Like, you know, like it's gonna be the situation to his health, you know, like, well, I'm gonna go with them because I'm gonna live, or I'm gonna eat tomorrow. Or I'm gonna go with them because I'm gonna live or eat tomorrow. And like the and they'll sell out each other real quick. And that shows me right there that what are they fighting for? I mean, they're kidding themselves. They don't really care. And the only place I've seen Arvins were riding around in mechanized vehicles, around big base camps, pulling security, having a nice vacation, walking around in press fatigues, you know, smoking dope, having a good time, you know. Well, we come in from a CA out in the field 28 days, you know, ringworm. I still got scars from them, man. And I'm just not gonna see, I just hate to see anybody go over there and do that shit, man. And like, I think every GI in the Army and anybody possibly going in should really take a look at what's happening, man. And try and decide for yourself, man, if you can.
I mean, like, what other country in the world lets all the people of the country carry arms? You know, like, all the people in North Vietnam are carrying weapons. I mean, that really shows that they support their government, not like in this country.
We got three branches of government who are basically doing the same thing. The executive branch of government, through Mitchell, says we're going to knock down, we're going to smash this movement before it gets underway. The Congress joins in by implementing repressive statutes such as the Interstate Riot Act. And the judicial branch of government joins this conspiracy by not throwing out the statute, by prosecuting the conspiracy and others like them.
See, I took my AIT at Fort Polk, Louisiana, which is not exactly one of the most integrated places in the world. And, well, when I went over there, it was three or four guys from up north and a bunch of southern crackers and a bunch of blacks, right? And we got over there and we stayed together for the most part. And when they're back in the States, the whites still had their prejudices. Like in the barracks at night, you know, like one end of the room would be the blacks, the other end of the room would be the southerners, you know, like, and us northerners would be wandering around in the middle with our fingers up our ass trying to figure out where to go. They come back to the States and, like John said, it's a lot different, you know, like we come back and we're heroes, you know. But a black guy comes back and he's got the same medals we do, you know, but it's just, hey boy, what do you want, you know? Why don't you get back where you belong in the ghettos, you know? And a lot of whites have come hip to the fact that it's wrong. It's ironic in a way that the establishment should build the solidarity which is gonna pull them down, but yet they're really doing it, whether they realize it or not.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, the foreign policy of this government cannot and will not be formulated by violence in the streets of Washington or in the streets of any other city in this nation.
Tuesday afternoon, we gathered in Lincoln Park to hear Bobby Seale, chairman of the Black Panther Party for Self-Defense.
All right, it's good to be here, to come out and speak to some people who are involved in a drastic situation of a developing revolution. The revolution in this country that's occurring is in fact people coming forth to demand freedom. Now, in just a second, there's a lesson that Minister of Defense Huey P. Newton teaches, that whenever the people disagree with the political decisions that's been made upon their heads, that whenever the people disagree with those political decisions, the racist power structure sends in guns and force to see that the people accept those political decisions. But we are here as revolutionaries to let them know that we refuse to accept those political decisions that maintain the oppression of our black people and other people in the world.
Justice Department.
Demonstrating on the street, you know, this whole revolution is to give somebody the opportunity to have a future.